The COVID-19 tally in India rose to 19,64,536 on Thursday after over 56,000 fresh cases were reported within a span of 24 hours. A major fire broke out in Ahmedabad's COVID hospital in the wee hours of Thursday. As many as 8 COVID patients, including 5 men and 3 women, died in the incident. Novavax on Wednesday announced that it had entered into a supply and license agreement with the Serum Institute of India for the development and commercialization of its COVID-19 vaccine candidate. UP Law Minister Brajesh Pathak on Wednesday tweeted that he had tested positive after he showed symptoms of COVID-19. Senior CPIM leader Shyamlal Chakrabarty died of COVID-19 at a hospital in Kolkata today. He was 76 years old. With over 18.8 million cases across the globe, vaccine trials are now being fast-tracked. As many as 708,278 deaths have been reported worldwide. A study has found that disulfiram, the medication used to treat alcoholism, may help to treat COVID-19. North Korea's Kaesong City, which is completely locked down because of the coronavirus, will soon get a supply of food and funds to stabilize living conditions for citizens. Singapore is monitoring a recent spate of suicides and attempted suicides involving migrants, which has heightened concerns over the mental health of thousands of low-paid workers confined to their dormitories in the city-state due to COVID-19. The US's leading infectious disease expert, Dr. Anthony Fauci, has said that while the world may never eradicate the coronavirus completely, public health measures and an effective vaccine could help bring it under control.